Assalamu alaikum, welcome to Times of Ummah. Today's first news update is coming from Egypt, where the Egyptian intelligence chief Abbas Kamil has visited Gaza and have met with the Palestinian group's leader in the besieged coastal enclave to try to bolster a ceasefire between Hamas and Israel. Viewers, the Hamas top official Khalil al-Haya has said Israel should stop aggression in the both Gaza Strip and West Bank if it really wants to maintain a serious ceasefire. The top Egyptian intelligence official have also met with the Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, and his trip was aimed to further strengthen ceasefire between Hamas and Israel. According to Egyptian and Palestinian officials, it was the first Egyptian intelligence chief visit to Gaza since 2000s, and his trip was also aimed to discuss reconstruction plans following the recent Israeli bombardment on Gaza. Al-Haya told to reporters that we discussed several files, most importantly the necessity to oblige the occupation to stop its aggression on Gaza, Jerusalem, Sheikh Jarrah, and all over the Palestine. He said Israel must also fully lift the blockade it imposed on Gaza when Hamas seized power from rival Palestinian force in 2007 after winning 2006 elections. He added, if this happens, then calm and stability could return. Dear viewers, the 11 days long war have took hundreds of Palestinian lives, and then Egypt played a pivotal role in brokering a ceasefire between Israel and Hamas, which governs the Gaza Strip. The flare-up in violence followed weeks of tensions in occupied East Jerusalem ahead of a now delayed court ruling on the forced expulsion of Palestinian families in the Sheikh Jarrah neighborhood. Israeli forces cracked down on protesters in the neighborhood and the nearby Al-Aqsa Mosque compound, which is revered by Muslims and Jews who call it the Temple Mount. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu got huge criticism for ceasefire with no conditions, and some officials have called it another failure of Netanyahu. The Kamil's visit is seen as an effort by Cairo to regain a more vital role in mediation between Israel and Hamas and revive styled Israel-Palestinian peace process. However, the Egyptian President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi directed officials to continue efforts and meeting to solve the problem of prisoners and missing people between Israel and Hamas. Viewers, as of now, this visit is so important for both sides, and it can pave a way for a permanent ceasefire if Israel seriously wants it to. Dear viewers, the intelligence chief of Cairo have met with the Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas in the occupied West Bank city of Ramallah on Sunday and handed him a message from al-Sisi affirming Cairo's support for Palestinian and Abbas. A permanent ceasefire is now the necessary there, and Egypt will try its best to bring both parties to peace. But a long-lasting ceasefire and peace is impossible till the end of the Jewish regime. Dear viewers, if you want to watch top news of the day, please subscribe Times of Ummah.